City center.
Leoni building.
Home sweet home.
Hot khichdi.
Being with international people.
Eating lots of Maggi.
Velodrome building.
B bar.
Just Kavali.
Old fashioned nightclub.
Yeah. Driving a Tesla.
Mountain biking.
Skiing in Salpa.
Walking barefoot on Navini at 2 a.m.
Fashion of Milan.
Milan Fashion Week, I wore.
I would say like in these four months there were three main milestones. The first was, to be frank, was BSCC, that is Bocconi Students Consulting Club. I'm a consulting club member at MISB Bocconi as well, so I was really passionate about getting into this consulting club for Bocconi University. Second thing was Bocconi and Jobs, as I mentioned earlier. I'd really prepared my CV, my profile, my HR interview questions really well, because I was targeting specific companies for Bocconi and Jobs. I got an opportunity to interview with PNG and also can say more or less interview with ENY, Italia. So PNG is something which I was able to really capitalize on. I got three rounds of interviews, one psychometric test, and I was able to make a cut for the Geneva, the Switzerland, the marketing, can say the marketing brain of PNG. Third thing, which was completely out of blue, was Whirlpool Business Hackathon, which I believe is the highlight of my 4 months. So they were organizing this business hackathon where they were putting up four different challenges, life problems which Whirlpool is facing in Europe and ways to solve them. So my team personally consisted of a girl from Tunisia, a couple of Italians, one person from Singapore, one German, and yeah, I'm from India. We ended up winning the competition, not just winning the competition, but my team is being currently evaluated for an emerging leader program by Whirlpool.
So Porsche Consulting was a part of my management consulting subject. So it was a competition which was organized for, I think, around 200 students. I was a part of the group. So I think there were three rounds for that. So the first round was a case study competition, which was given to us orally by the professor. And he told us that the group that presents the best solution will be invited by Porsche Consulting for an assessment. And out of that, three students will be selected to work with Porsche Consultants for full time for 2 days. And we got selected, we were called for the assessment. So we had an assessment for nearly 4.5 hours where we were tested on our quantitative skills, case study solving skills, case interviewing skills, our finance knowledge, pretty much everything, the way you sit, the way you talk, the presentation skills, Italian skills, obviously. So we always see Milan Fashion Week, or we at least, you know, hear of Milan Fashion Week, Paris Fashion Week, London Fashion Week as being the three most, I would say, reputed and the most prestigious fashion events. So, and none of us ever expect, you know, that okay, one of us might someday, somewhere down the line, be a part of this event. But I was able to do that purely through networking, and because I was able to speak Italian. It was purely because of that. And I was able to speak to, it's like, you know, I speak to person X, and then the person X tells me go to person Y, and person Y tells me go to person A. So it's like hustling. Simple hustling, you know, don't stop till you get what you want. And that is what I did with Milan Fashion Week, and I was really happy to work there, to at least, you know, witness, to be a part of it, to be wearing that ID card that says with my name, okay, part of the Milan Fashion Week. So that is really amazing for me, because when I told my friends that I actually worked, no one believed me. Then I had to show them the inside photos, you know, the backstage photos, and then they were like, okay, that he has really been there. So it's all on you, what you make of it.
A framework to apply for a Milan semester as well. On campus, for me, it was academic, non-academic. And outside campus, it was everything apart from being academic. So on campus, I focused on getting projects from courses, getting internships, networking with guest speaker sessions. And outside campus, partying, traveling, adventure sports, and more partying.
I already knew what I wanted to do. It's not that I went there and then I decided to do. So I was like, for example, I was really sharpening my Italian like anything, and I did a very good thing of staying in the hostel, staying in the college dorms. And I also spoke Italian, so it was very easy for me to network with all these people. Some of us who have never traveled outside India, for them it was a fantastic experience, because you have that sense of freedom, and I would say the sense of empowerment that you get, you know, when you're traveling by yourself. You have a totally different level of maturity whenever you're traveling to different places, especially if you go to Florence. or Rome, these are really, I would say, high pulse places where you meet different people of different types, or different cultures. You taste different types of food, even if you're in Italy, but you'll get every type of food. So I think that was a very amazing experience. You know, you have like unity in diversity. That's how we used to term it there. So it was really cool.